Hey everyone, John Henry here, SlingshotFutures.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to trade probabilities and adjust when they change. You know, one of the biggest things that a lot of people do is they'll look at a specific setup and say, okay, well, I know that this setup has about a 60% chance of being successful. Okay, that's great, but the thing is, as the market's moving and as things change, those probabilities also change. And that's one of the pitfalls that a lot of traders will run into is not adjusting accordingly when those probabilities shift. So let's take, you know, an example of a potential trade setup here, and let's look at, I don't know, the NASDAQ. So we have a possible short in the NASDAQ, looking good, coming back to the moving average, and maybe you're looking to short here, okay? And we're looking at a situation of saying, okay, well, I know that if I short here underneath a strong enough bear bar, we've had two legs to the upside, we're coming back to a structural level of resistance, looks like a pretty good place to get in short, right? So that is a short area that a lot of sellers will sell into, assuming that it's going to continue breaking down. The trend is down, the 4-hour chart's bearish, the hourly chart's bearish, pretty much every chart that you can throw at right now is bearish on the NASDAQ. So a lot of sellers will jump into the short and they'll say, okay, you know what, I'm going to jump in short underneath this strong bear bar. And I'm going to put a stop above the highs, and I'm going to be looking for a move back down to the lows, right? And I know that I have a chance of about 60% of that occurring and happening successfully. But here's the thing, right? We look at this move and we say, okay, well, it moved down, it went in our favor, and then we were red. And then it went back in our favor, and then we were red again. And now it's back in our favor again, down to a new low, comes back, holds break even, but it's not breaking down. So we look at this and say, okay, well, where does the probability shift? Well, we had a situation of a possible short. We know the stop is above the high, so the target is going to be at least 1-to-1. Eyeballing it, this isn't perfect, but right around here, to potentially, you know, 1.5-to-1 or maybe a 2-to-1, etc. And we're looking for that down move, and we're not getting it, right? Now, it does have an initial drive lower that works out nicely. There's no cause for concern here. It's holding the break-even point, so sellers are still selling. No reason to really be concerned. But when I have a situation where I get in short, and it goes in my favor and then goes against me, right? I'm sitting in the red, then it comes back and goes in my favor again. I no longer want to give that trade a chance to turn into a loss. The probabilities have shifted. If I was right, right, and I was 100% accurate, which is non-existent, it doesn't happen in the markets, but if it was a 100% accurate trade, it would have rocket shipped straight down into my target. But it didn't, right? Now, just because it didn't doesn't mean that I'm just, oh, get out of the trade. No, but we have to adjust based on what the market is telling us. And it's telling us that the sellers may not be as strong as we once thought they were. So we go up and we're negative, goes back down in our favor, we're positive, goes back up, we're negative, goes back down, we're positive. But what do we have here, right? It's all wicks. We're not getting any confirmation, right? Nothing's happening. It's just a bunch of wicks. But when we get a strong bear bar, fails to break through, comes back, tries to break down again, and fails again, now the probability has officially shifted. We've gone from a 60% probable trade down to a 35 to 40% probable trade. And that shift means that your risk reward needs to be adjusted. Right now, the reason behind why that would need to happen is simply because of math. If we kind of take a step back and look at the common sense side of things, right? Let's say that as an example, I buy here. And my stop is here, and my target is here. What's the probability of being successful on this trade? Not very high. It's a lot easier for the market to move down and hit my stop than it is to move in my favor and hit my target. So this trade, right out of the gates, by default, is probably only going to be, I mean, that's like a 4-to-1 reward versus risk. It's probably only going to be right 30% of the time. You're not going to have that trade play out very well, very often. But when it does, it's pretty lucrative, right? You get a huge return versus your risk. The other side of things is taking it to another drastic extreme would be having a stop way down here and a target like this. Common sense would say it's going to be pretty darn easy for me to hit my target compared to my stop, right? The market's got to move a ton more to take me out. And on a trade like this, you could be right 80% of the time, right? It's just the times that you're wrong hurts a heck of a lot. Generally speaking, the market operates between a band of 60 and 40%. We talk about that a lot. I say that a lot. I'm kind of a broken record when it comes to that. General probability, without taking anything into consideration, is throwing a dart at a wall, 40 to 60% probability band of being successful. Now, this is why this is so important when you adjust for risk reward, because if you took the trade assuming that you were going to be right 60% of the time, well, if I'm going to be right 60% of the time, I can use a wider stop. Right? And my target will be, you know, a little bit wider as well, generally a 1-to-1 kind of trade. So if I'm risking 40 ticks and I'm right 60% of the time, That means that 60% of the time, I'm making 40 ticks, and 40% of the time, I'm losing 40 ticks. 40 times 40 is 1600, 60 times 60, I'm sorry, 40 times 60 is 2400. 2400 minus 1600, pretty easy math, that's a profitable strategy, right? So a one-to-one strategy is fine. But when we see a shift in probability like we have here, now you're trading assuming that the probabilities haven't changed if you don't adjust your strategy. So if you do not adjust your strategy, you're now trading a one-to-one risk with a 40% chance of being successful. So the probabilities have completely shifted. So now let's look at the math, right? It's backward. Now we're taking 1600 minus 2400. We are now net negative in the long term. If you don't touch your stop, you don't move anything, you don't adjust for the probability shift. And this is where a lot of people just can't simply get over that hump of being a successful trader or a profitable trader, or half the time, heck, even a break-even trader, because they're not adjusting when the market is giving you more information. They're just assuming that the probabilities have stayed the same regardless of what has happened. And that's just simply not the case. You need to be adjusting, or it's recommended to be adjusting when the probabilities change, because this trade went from a beautiful mathematical trade in the green to a horrible mathematical trade in the green that needs to be adjusted correctly. Now, how do we adjust this probability, right? Well, we adjust the probability by doing what? We know that if the probability is low, that means that our target needs to be bigger compared to our stop. Okay, easy peasy. If I'm short from here, and my stop was originally here, and my target is down here for a 60% trade, a one-to-one, and now we have proof, or a probabilistic proof, that we are now dealing with a 40% trade, I have every reason in the world to move my stop above this bear bar, I'm sorry, above this bull bar, because if that triggers, now I know something's probably wrong. And now we're dealing with a beautiful risk reward again, right? We're dealing with a risk reward of, man, like 7 to 1. The probability of me being able to stay in that trade is very low because my stop is so close to the market. But if I'm able to, I'm going to get paid very well. Now there's two sides to this coin. What did we do, right? We changed not the strategy, our approach was the same, but the market didn't follow through. And that lack of follow through shifts the probability. So because of that shift in probability, we reduce the risk while maintaining a large target. Because if we're going to be right and this trade is going to roll over, it's going to pay me well. But if I'm wrong and because of the probability shift, I'm not going to lose that much. If anything, some traders will just go to break even. So when I'm in a situation like this and I'm short and I'm looking at it, it's like, yeah, it's looking great. Oh crap, that's not good. Well, that's even worse. Oh man, something's happening. When you're saying that, something has changed, right? The probabilities have changed. You need to adjust your trade so that you stay mathematically sound in the long run. Everything is all numbers, right? When you boil everything down. And in this type of situation, this is where it's very favorable to adjust your probability on the trade and say, okay, we no longer have that high probability that I was looking for. I need to adjust to make this so that in the long run, mathematically, it's still good. And in this case, it would have stopped you out at a very small loss, maybe 4 or 5 ticks, while your open target was still hundreds of ticks. And that's the way that they need to be approached. Anytime you're getting into a situation where it's just not doing what it's supposed to, or it's just falling short a little bit, it's not getting that oomph that you were really expecting, or it's not doing what you were expecting, something has changed, right? And sometimes you won't have that. You know, sometimes you'll see a bear bar like this in a beautiful condo, man alive, short the heck out of it. Put the stop above it and wham, bam, there's your target, right? You don't even have to think about it. It's easy. But the times that the market makes you think about it is the time that you really need to think about it and say, wait a minute, if I keep my trade the same way that it is right now, in the long run, I'm going to be losing, right? It doesn't make any sense to leave it that way anymore because something is wrong. I need to adjust my approach to put the edge back in my court, right? And if it's not in my court, I'm not in the trade. I don't want it. Something to think about, and something that a lot of traders don't think about, and I think that's why so many traders probably fail. But either way you look at it, something that might be interesting, or maybe not, maybe you already do this. If you do, awesome work. But hopefully you found it interesting, at least. Hopefully you found it useful, and maybe something you can add to your tool belt. Something I would personally really, I would really strongly consider wanting to look at if you find yourself really getting hammered on those losing days and not doing that great to overcome those losing days with the winning days. Probably because you're not adjusting the trade correctly. something to think about. But anyway, that's going to do it for this one. Underneath the video, make sure to give the video a thumbs up, give us a like. Along with that, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you click the notification bell icon to the right of that so you don't miss any of these videos. We usually upload one Monday through Thursday. Fridays, sometimes, sometimes not. But you don't want to miss any of them so that you don't miss anything important. That's going to do it, though. As always, if you have any questions about it, feel free to shoot me an email, jbrink@slingshotfutures.com. Until the next video, I hope you had a fantastic trading day today. I hope you have a fantastic trading day tomorrow and for the rest of the week. And that's going to do it. So enjoy, and we'll see you all in the next one. Thanks.